Let us solve the next sum. Third one, draw an obtuse angle triangle and right angle triangle. Find the points of concurrence of the angle bisectors of each triangle. Where do the point of concurrence lie? So we are going to first draw obtuse angle triangle, and after that we are going to draw right angle triangle. So let us draw first obtuse angle triangle by using scale. So let us name this triangle as A, B and C. So after it is said draw an obtuse angle triangle, and then it is said right angle triangle which we are going to draw afterwards, then it is said find the points of concurrence of the angle bisectors of each triangle. So always note what has been given, angle bisector. Okay, so we have to draw angle bisector by using compass. Okay, so for angle bisector you have to put keep your compass on one point vertex. Like if first I have kept it on B because I am going to draw angle bisector for angle B here, which is obtuse angle. Okay, so draw arc on one side of the angle, then another arc on another side of the angle. As we get two arcs and two intersection point, put on the two intersection point, draw one arc here, then put on another intersection point and so after intersecting this arc we get one intersection point. We have to join the two points, point B and the intersection point. Okay, so this is one angle bisector. Now another angle is angle C. This is angle C. So angle C also we have to draw angle bisector. So put on point C, intersect, draw arc on both the sides of the angle, both the hands of the angle, then we get two intersection points. Draw an arc here, don't get confused students. Okay, so we get this intersection point here. Okay, so join the intersection point and point C by a line. This is the intersection point, this is point C, now the remaining angle is angle A. Angle C is done, angle B is done, and this is angle A. Okay, I have represented each angle with different symbol. Why? Because every angle has different measures. Okay, so put on point A, then draw arc on each hands of the angle, then we get these two points. Here I'll rub this a little bit so that there will be less confusion, right? One arc is done and then do another arc. Okay. After drawing this, join the point at angle A and the intersection point. So now you think and tell me which is the point of concurrence. So the point where all the three angle bisectors meet. This is one angle bisector. This is another angle bisector and this is third angle bisector. All these three angle bisectors meet at one point and that point is called as point of concurrence. So I'll call this point as point I. Okay. So this is for obtuse angle triangle where I is the point of concurrence. Now one more triangle is remaining, which is right angle triangle. So let us draw that. Take new page and first draw right angle triangle using scale and protractor also. So first draw the base. Let's draw the base of the triangle. Yes, after drawing the base, this is the segment. So on one end point of the segment, you have to keep the protractor and take 90 degree on the protractor. Don't make mistakes, okay? So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90. Okay, so we get 90 degree angle and then join these two points to make a triangle. So we get a right angled triangle. Why is it called a right angled triangle? Because one angle is 90 degree. Okay, we'll name this triangle as X, Y and Z. Now again of this triangle, we have to draw angle bisectors as been told in the question. Okay. So first I will draw angle bisector of angle Y. So what you have to do is put the pointer on angle Y and draw an arc on both the sides of an angle. Okay, both the sides. Then put the point on the one intersection point. Draw an arc. Then on another intersection point and again draw an arc. After drawing that, we get intersection point. Join these two points. So this is the angle bisector of right angle triangle or 90 degree angle. So this is one angle, this is another angle, angle Z. So angle, one angle has been bisected. Let us bisect angle Z. So to bisect, first we have to put the pointer on the angle Z and draw arc on both the sides of the hands of the angle, then again use the compass, draw arcs and get the intersection point, then pass a line through the intersection point and the angle Z. Now which is the remaining angle which is to be bisected? Angle X. Okay, so again repeat the same method. Put it on X. after getting the intersection point, join the angle and the intersection point. So this is the point of concurrence, we'll call it as again I. So here also I is the point of concurrence.